So I am sitting on the stairs, a little bit of a strange place to start my video, but I am here because I need to bring something up the stairs. I need to bring something up to the blue and white farmhouse bedroom that is waiting for me because there are a lot of DIY jobs that I need to do. It has been a while and I'm very excited. I'm very excited to get back into it. I'm very excited about finishing this project. It is going to be a lovely, lovely room. But I'm also very, very sad. Something very, very sad happened 2 days ago. And even though I do feel very excited about getting back into this whole blue and white farmhouse bedroom makeover, I also have a very, very sad heart. And I am going to tell you a little bit about it, of course. Hopefully without crying, probably not. I think for me right now it is very important to be here and to be active and to just do some things with my hands, you know, do some work with my hands. It is going to make me feel better. Maybe in this video I will be a little bit less outgoing than how I normally am, but that's just the way it is right now. So let me bring up the thing and let me show it to you. It is actually a bed. We actually already had a bed for this bedroom. It was something that Rogier still had lying around. A very old, beautiful, little antique bed. But I have a second one that I absolutely love. And I need to make the decision about which bed I want to use for this bedroom. I would like to use the bed that I have over here right now because it doesn't require any work, and the other one does a lot of it, and it would make this whole project a little bit more simple if I'm going to use this one. I'm also very curious to hear your opinion about this bed. I think it is absolutely gorgeous. I bought it secondhand on Marketplace for I think about 70 euros. Not bad for a bed, not bad for a bed like this. And yeah, let's bring it up first and let's take a look at it. Let's see if I can make a decision about which of the two beds I want to use. Wow. Okay, let's put it over here for a moment. Yesterday, Rogier and I, we took a little bit of time to clean up this room because it was a little bit of a mess. Also, when you are planning to do a lot of DIY jobs, obviously you are going to be tired. And accidents happen, especially when you are tired. And the same thing goes for being a little bit emotional. And I think it is a very nice thing to keep your workspace organized and clean, because it really helps with not getting those accidents. Trust me, I learned that the hard way. I really learned that the hard way. I had so many stupid accidents. What I love about this bed is, first of all, the shape of the headboard and all the little details that it has also over here. I think they are very beautiful. It's very French. What I also love a lot about this bed is the color, especially in combination with the blue on the walls,
because blue is quite a cold color and I do want this room to have a warm feel. I think the color of this wood is absolutely gorgeous in combination with the colors in the room.
The issue that I am having with the first bed is not really that it is broken, because fixing it is not really a problem. What is a problem is that this bed is covered in some sort of a waxy substance, and I do want to paint it because it is very, very dark. And if I want to paint that bed, it means that I have to remove all of that wax, and it is going to be very difficult. And if I do not have to, honestly, I rather not. If I can be a little bit lazy, I definitely want to do that.
So the issue with this bed is the headboard. It is very high, and my plan was to put the bed over here like this. That's why I also created this little cabinet over there, because I was planning to use this as a little nightstand. A nightstand that is hiding away in the wall, and the headboard was supposed to go over here. But because this headboard is so high, you can obviously see that this is not going to fit over there. So what I need to figure out if I want to use this bed is where I'm going to put it. So I think with this bed I have two options. I can place it over here and then the headboard is going to be on this wall, or I can place it over here like this and then the headboard will be on this wall. So what I would like to do is put it together real quick and just move it around a little bit to see how I like it. If I do not like it, I do have to use the other bed.
This was actually my son's bed. He is 19, and if you have seen more of my videos, you know that a little while ago he moved out, and he's doing very well, by the way, and so am I. It is very peaceful, very quiet, but very peaceful at my place. I do miss him, but I see him a lot. So he moved out and I had this bed, and I want to change that room into some sort of a studio space, so the bed needed to come out.
So with very old beds like this, usually they come with little openings, and on the sideboard they have little hooks. It's very simple, you put the little hooks in the little openings and that's it, right? Not quite. This situation over here is not a very strong and solid bond, and it does hold up the bed, so it is not going to fall apart, but there's a lot of movement, and I did figure out something to make that a lot better. I already did that when my son was using it, so if I'm going to use this bed, I'm definitely going to show you how I did that. But for now, it is not important at all. We are not going to sleep in it yet. Even though this is a very simple system, putting a bed like this together when you are alone can be a little bit tricky. That's why I always like to raise one end of the bed to about the same height as the little openings over there. And then it is very easy to slot in the little hooks in the little openings. As you can see, there is so much movement in this bed. Also over here, I don't know if you can see this, but there is a crack in the wood and all of this is moving. So this is something that I do need to fix. A little tiny DIY fix. I need to glue all of that back together. And I even think that on the other side, do you see that? Over here, it is actually doing the same. So I can already see right now that this is not a good place for this bed because it is blocking the entire room completely. I feel very cramped when I walk in here right now. So let's try it on the other wall. And maybe just for fun, try it over there. It's probably not going to look right, but let's try it anyway.
So it is not working on that wall. It is definitely not working in front of the window. So let's try the last option.
I think this is it. I think this is going to work. This is just such a small space and the bed is just very big. It doesn't matter which bed I'm going to use. It is going to be big in this space. And I actually think that this is not bad. It is not bad at all. I can even decide to move it in that direction a little bit more to create a little bit more space over here. I think I have some space on this side or on this side for the beautiful white cabinet. I can hang something nice above the bed, and the gallery wall that I was planning to create on this wall just has to move over here. So I think we have a winner. If you did not see the other bed at all and you are wondering what bed was she talking about, I will link the video in my descriptions with a timestamp with it so you can look it up and you can check it out.
So I guess I'm going to take it apart again. I'm going to put it away for now and I'm going to bring a different project up the stairs. A project that is actually going to involve some DIY that I'm going to start today. It's a chair. It is a chair that I found in the trash, and it is not the best looking chair. I mean, it is nice, it has a very nice shape, but it could use a little bit of love.
Let's see if I still have some secondhand sanding paper that I can use for projects like this. Something like a chair, it is always nice to just use some old pieces of sanding paper that you still have lying around. Sanding is one of my least favorite things to do, and I want to get this over with quickly. It's very, very gross. Sanding that chair took me all night yesterday, so it is the next morning. Sanding is done, I also gave it a good clean, and I received something in the mail this morning. So let's open this box, because in this box is everything that I need for the seat of the chair. What I'm going to do with the seat of the chair is something called buyer's bond. Buyer's bond is a way of doing embroidery. It is a typical Dutch thing, and I am very excited about it, but on the other hand, also not so much, because if there is anything at all that I do not really like doing, it is doing arts and crafts with fabrics. But it is going to be fine. It is going to be fine. Okay, so let's see. I ordered some yarn. This is exactly the right color that I need for this fabric. They actually tell you in this webshop what kind of yarn you need to order, which is very nice. I also bought this book that has all the stitches in it. I actually already had this book, but I cannot seem to find it anywhere. So I ordered myself a new one. It is not even 3 euros, so it's not a very big expense. Over here you see all of the stitches. I think it also has a little bit of extra information, I think, about buyer's bond. Maybe I should read this to see if I can find out a little bit more about the history of buyer's bond. Aprons, tablecloths, curtains.
And that's it. Very small, very small book. But I think it is going to be helpful. And then, of course, I have the fabric. And I ordered a little bit extra because maybe it is also nice to make a little pillow from this fabric for the bed.
Before I can start my little Beyers Bond adventure, I want to remove the old fabric from the seat and I need to paint this chair. Okay, change of outfit because I am and I will always be a very, very messy painter. I also have two screwdrivers. This fabric on the chair is attached with staples and usually I use screwdrivers to get them out. Can I pull it? I think I can. That's going to save me so much time. Nope. I thought I was very lucky, but I'm not. Because I am pulling the fabric away, but the staples are still in here. So if you want to find me, I will be here. So what I'm doing is, I put my screwdriver underneath the staple. And then I pull one end out. Then I pull away the fabric. Because it is much easier to see the staples when you have them sitting in plain wood. And then instead of grabbing and pulling, I am actually, I don't know if you can see this, I am grabbing and turning. Much easier. I can understand that people like to put in a lot of staples because it is just such a satisfying thing to do, but taking all of those staples out. Oh, God. Not so much. The seat of this chair is crumbling a little bit. And that happens a lot with very old chairs. I don't know if you can see this, but it is falling apart. I do think that I can still reuse this. I have seen a lot worse. I actually quite like the inside of this fabric. The outside, not so much. Inside, not bad at all. I might even keep this. Maybe it would be fun to do something with this. Recycle. I am actually feeling excited about this piece of fabric because it has some very nice warm colors and I can use something like this in this room. This chair is not put together with screws or anything like that, but with wooden pegs. And I actually think that this is an antique chair. I think it is actually quite old. It is just the seat that has been replaced. The seat is actually not even a very good fit. It is very badly made, but like I said before, I really feel like being lazy, so I am going to keep it. I'm going to keep it, and I think we are ready to start painting this chair. So, there is no footage of me painting this chair. I actually am at home right now, because I need to water my houseplants, and I was just editing this video, and I found out that all of the footage is missing. I don't know what happened. But in my defense, it was a little bit of a strange week. I actually did bring the chair over here because I want to continue working on this chair even if I am not over there. And I guess I am going to show it to you. So at least you have a little bit of an idea about how it looks like right now. So I'm going to grab the chair and I am going to show it to you real quick. So here it is. I decided to paint this chair in the same creamy white that I also used for the baseboards and the door trim and some other things. Of course, it is going to need another coat of paint or maybe even two. I do think that when this chair is finished, it is going to be very creative, very original and very, very Dutch. I also promised to share a little bit more about why I have been feeling so sad
for the last few days. And before I left, I actually recorded a little video. I decided to make it into a separate video because I did not really feel like it belonged in a DIY video. And I am a little bit hesitant about uploading this video because I was feeling very emotional, and sharing such deep emotions on YouTube is not something that I find very easy to do. But I decided that I am going to upload it. Rogier actually convinced me to do so. And I guess you can decide for yourself if you want to watch it. I am going to upload it on the same day as this video, so it will be online right now. For now, Pippi and I, we want to thank you so much for watching this video. We really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please let us know by giving it a thumbs up. And I really hope to see you next week. Bye! Bye! Bye!
Hey, Pippi!